this Parliament is allowed to function as the true voice of the people of England, and not as a gathering of lackeys to the king.
You may be assured I do not intend now to be schooled in my high office by illiterate farmhands, cobblers, and basket weavers.
Any action against any member of this house is a breach of privilege. And I move this house declares us public enemies, any who lay hands upon its members.
Mr. Speaker, you will inform the members of this house that their presence is no longer required by the nation. This Parliament is, by my authority, terminated.
Are you aware that by your action in this house today, you may have pushed this nation to the brink of civil war?
Johnny, come marching home again, hurrah, tra-la. It's coming by bus or on the ground, hurrah, tra-la. The woman got a shed a tear to see his face so beaten and fair. Just around the corner.
Nation back its self-respect. We will walk in this world with our heads held high. I will liberate man's souls from the darkness of ignorance. I will build schools and universities for all. This will become the golden age of learning. I will bring the law within the reach of every common man. There'll be work and bread for all. This nation will prosper because it is a godly nation and because we walk hand in hand with the Lord.
Oliver Cromwell ruled the nation as Lord Protector for 5 years. In that short time, he raised England to be a great power, feared and respected throughout the world. Under his hand were laid the foundations of a truly democratic nation. In 1658, he died. 3 years later, Charles, Prince of Wales, was crowned king, and the monarch sat once more upon the throne of England. But an England never to be the same again.